Back in March, when my husband and I had first started to self-isolate, we noticed that our cat was starting to go bald. He was balding around his little ears, and he was balding on the top of his head, and it was clearly getting worse, so much so that the backs of his legs started to lose fur, and so we were getting worried. So we contacted our vet, and luckily she had started to take telehealth visits. So this was actually really interesting because my cat is super aggressive. He is not nice to people who are not me and my husband. And so over this video chat, we were basically able to get up close and personal with my cat, see the scabbing on his ears, and better diagnose him. I mean, better than we would have even been able to do if we were able to go into the vet. This whole experience got me wondering what other veterinary practices were doing as people were self-isolating and sort of operating under quarantine.
So Josh, can you tell me if you've had to shift care at all because of the circumstances we're now living in?
So Smolder is a membership-based veterinary model. We set out about a year and a half ago to really reimagine what the veterinary experience looks like, what it feels like. A digital offering, which includes 24/7 telemedicine, a robust mobile app, digital booking, digital messaging. These have always been a part of our offering. COVID really just gave us an opportunity to refocus our attention on those aspects of our business. You know, to provide safety for our team, we've implemented a drop-off procedure. That's really to provide safety for our team and also to provide safety to our members. And then, you know, the member can call us from outside on their phones or on FaceTime and participate in the appointment that way without being in the room. We've also implemented video consults. So, if you drop off the pet, you can communicate via video from the sidewalk or watch through the window. But if you prefer not to come at all, you can do a video consult from home, right? And so those are some of the things we've added. And then to help our members and pets get to our facility, we've implemented subsidized pickup and drop off. And so that's been very popular, increasing in volume over the past 2 months.
What are some of the innovations you think that you will keep from like what you're doing right now for the long term?
Yeah, I think telemedicine is, it was always a part of our offering, but I think COVID has opened up our members to its potential. Usage is way up. Almost 80% of our members have now used telemedicine. That's much higher than it was before COVID set in. And I think usage will remain higher than it was pre-COVID, frankly, because it's convenient. Veterinary medicine in many ways is less developed in telemedicine than human medicine, interestingly. And so there's a long way to go. There's a lot of opportunity in veterinary medicine. And I think over the next decade, you're going to see a lot of innovation, a lot of evolution in the regulations and some of the things that are impeding or have impeded its growth historically.
Smolder was one of a few veterinary practices that were starting to use technology even before people began quarantining. But now that there have been so many limits on how people move about the world, more veterinary practices are embracing technology and telehealth. In fact, the American Veterinary Medical Association has started to provide tools to help veterinary practices engage more with technology, engage more with telehealth in order to keep their practices running, and also in order to help people access more veterinary care for their pets.